Okay, interview with Gary Setchell at a loud Harborough after Bedford Town 3, Harborough Town 1. Setch, a good workout on a Friday night and one of, I feel, the best performance of pre-season yet.
First half, yeah, done really well. I thought defensively, you know, like I just said to the boys, every pre-season game there's positives and the negatives. And I thought positive, I thought our front three were very good tonight. Well, front six were very good tonight. But I thought, you know, the back four was not winning the first balls tonight for whatever reason. And the goal we give away is absolutely criminal. Long throw, flicked on, running in behind. It's just such a sloppy goal to give away. And that, we hadn't been doing that, to be fair, against, you know, very good opposition. And, you know, Mitch's team was a different test for us tonight. You know, they've got the long throw, they've got big lads, they've got lads who are dominant from set pieces. And that's something we had to defend. And, you know, by hook or by crook, we sort of just about got away with it. And obviously, their gaffer had some words at half-time, and they came out second half a little bit of a different animal, and they, you know, they closed us down a lot quicker and stopped us playing. But then both teams made change, and that just ended up being a friendly. But first half for us certainly was very, very positive.
Do you feel as if it was therefore worthwhile switching the game from tomorrow, with the temperature being not as hot looking forward towards to a Friday night? Obviously a different exposure to the Friday night gives.
Yeah, I think, you know, I think they was a lot of players short. You know, we're missing four or five compared to Charlie, Will, but Max, Sean. So, you know, and I think they were missing 67 as well. So it's always a little bit of a false entity. But, you know, it's a great workout, you know, lovely club. I get on really well with Mitch, and, you know, that'll be fine this year, you know, as will we be.
The lads you just mentioned there, is there any injuries or is it just unavailability?
Well, we moved it on the Friday late. I mean, Butts would have been able to play, but then he got injured and jarred his knee on Tuesday night. Will was not available. Sean's picked up a knock. Pedro's on his honeymoon. Charlie can play on Friday. So that's just a bit unfortunate, but like I say, that's another good workout. There was a lot of positives tonight. And like I say, especially the front six first half, I thought we'd really good. And obviously there's always negatives, which was we didn't defend the first ball tonight as well as I'd have liked to do.
Some of the Harbour fans saying that they were missing quite a few tonight, with the school holidays and stuff like that tonight. I think we've obviously missed a few there. Do you feel the two strongest sides would really give a good competitive game, considering obviously their step four?
Yeah, I mean, they're going to be a good step forward side. There's no question about that. They had a great season last season. They won the treble. But we're a good side as well. And, you know, players missing. You know, certainly Pedro and Charlie helped with the long throws. I think Pedro will come and catch a few of them. We'll certainly get something on them. And obviously Charlie's a huge lad as well. But listen, we might draw him in the cup or whatever. To be fair, you wouldn't want to come down there in the cup, would you? That'd be sort of November, that'd be blowing a gale, that'd be freezing, they're long for that'd be horrible. But yeah, I think that'd be, you know, we'll probably play these every year, well, certainly while I'm here and mixes at Harbour, so hopefully next time we can get both full teams on the pitch and have a proper competitive friendly. Not saying tonight weren't competitive, but obviously that weren't probably the two first full teams.
Any signings news?
Well, you did first know, James, you're the secretary, so maybe, you know, we're still looking to bring one or two in, maybe even three. We know the areas that we need to strengthen, so, you know, we're always looking, but like I say, that's got to be the right player at the right price at the right time, and if not, we'll run with what we've got. We're not far away, you know, even with a full set of players, we've got a team more than capable of competing in step three, but obviously we want to add them little bits of quality to try and get us near the top of end, you know, certainly top half of the table. And if we do, we feel we can do it. And, you know, with the momentum we got from last year and, you know, the work ethic that we always have, you just don't know how far that can carry us.
Big week coming back after the year, obviously Kendall National League side coming and then Wilstone coming, a National League side again. Step up back into pre-season, there's something to aspire to, performance is needed.
To be honest, I'm more looking forward to the training session on Thursday, because we've just gone game, and we lost the training session because we moved this to the Friday. It's a bit of a pain really, because there's stuff we need to work on. And, you know, since the first week of pre-season we got to, but then we've got a couple of free weeks towards the back end of pre-season. We can get four or five good training sessions in as well, and we'll start working on the shape and patterns and stuff like that.
Just finally, fixtures came out today. Obviously, we start away to Stratford, then home to Barwell, Kingsley, Angley. You know, a reasonably okay start considering the paper, even though it will, of course, be difficult to spend three games just like that. What's your thoughts?
I'd like the home game, if I'm being honest, with the buzz. but yet you just don't know. Stratford could be one of the best teams in the league. We don't really know. We know they've made a few signs. We know they've got a high profile manager in Dean Holdsworth. So what's that, a wait and see? You just you'll never know until 12 games. But on paper, like you say, if you're going on last year's league table, then you know we've got some 50-50 games early on, and hopefully ones that we can get results in.
The music's still going, but the interview's over. So we will see you back at the Erie on Tuesday and Saturday. Hemel and Willstone, get your tickets now at BedfordEagles.com.